Hello everyone. In my today's lecture, I will be talking about total knee replacement. So myself, Dr. Sneha Bhatia, MPT in Orthopedics and Sports Rehabilitation, in charge principal at Late Srimati S.G. Patel Institute of Physiotherapy. So before I start with my lecture, I would like to request my audience to please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get notified for the next video. So TKR or total joint arthroplasty or total knee replacement is a very vast topic. In this video, I have tried to give brief outline about total knee replacement. So joint replacement is a procedure whereby one or both the components forming a joint are replaced with artificial component. So the artificial components are called as prostheses. So this is the normal anatomy of the knee joint, as we can see in the front view, side view and the back view. So front view, we can see the patella, the femur and the tibia and fibula. Side view also, we can see all these three bones, and the posterior view is on the right hand side of the picture. So these are the movements available at the knee joint. We have mainly the flexion and extension movement, which is the primary movement at the knee joint. There is also rotation that is occurring at the knee joint, and some amount of abduction and adduction is also present at the knee joint. So damaged articular surface is sliced off to prepare the bone ends to take the artificial component which cap the ends of the bones, more appropriately called a knee resurfacing operation. So what is happening in the total knee replacement or TKR is the surgeon is removing the affected portion, the damaged portion which is having the osteoarthritic degenerative changes, that is removed in the surgical procedure, and implant is put in place. So indication for the total knee replacement: osteoarthritis, primary kind of osteoarthritis and secondary type of osteoarthritis. In both the osteoarthritis, TKR can be done. In case of rheumatoid arthritis also, TKR procedure can be done. Contraindication: so there are two types of contraindication, absolute contraindication and relative contraindication. Absolute contraindication for TKR is sepsis, insufficient extensor mechanism and neuropathic joint. Relative type of contraindication for TKR is younger patient. Suppose if the patient is less than 50 years of age, obesity, if the patient is having obesity and demanding profession, patient is involved in any demanding profession, then TKR can be done, but we have to take care of certain factors. So risk factors for the osteoarthritis of the knee joint are increasing age. So as the patient ages, there are more chances of degenerative changes. Obesity, if the patient is obese and having overweight, then there are chances that the knee joint will have more amount of wear and tear, and the patient may require TKR in the later life. So female gender is also more prone for osteoarthritic changes compared to male. Trauma, infection and repetitive occupational trauma, all these are the factors which causes degenerative changes in the knee joint and causes osteoarthritis of the knee joint. So clinical features of the OA knee, that depends on the stage of involvement. So in the OA knee, we can have pain as a symptom, loss of function, swelling, stiffness, deformity and crepitus. These are the signs and symptoms that the patient of OA knee will have. So the history of TKR, how it started. So it started as back as 1816. So resection arthroplasty was first done in 1860s. In 1940s, first artificial implants were tried when molds were fitted in the femoral condyle. In 1950s, combined femoral and tibial articular surface replacement appeared as simple hinges. So implant, what are the components of the implant which are used for the TKR? So in the picture, we can see the parts of an artificial joint. We have the femoral component, the patellar button, the plastic spacer and the tibial base plate. So first we have a U-shaped femoral component. टू कैप द प्रीपेड लोअर एंड ऑफ द फीमर. वी हैव अ टीबियल बेस प्लेट टू कवर द कट फ्लैट सरफेस ऑफ द अपर एंड ऑफ द टीबिया. इधर बोथ क्रूशिएट्स और ओनली एंटीरियर क्रूशिएट इज एक्साइज्ड. अ प्लास्टिक ट्रे इज इंसर्टेड बिटवीन द अबाउ टू मेटालिक कंपोनेंट्स एंड अ पटेलार बटन मेड अप ऑफ पोलीइथिलीन टू रिप्लेस द डैमेज सरफेस ऑफ द पटेला. सो दीज आर द पार्ट्स ऑफ द इम्प्लांट विच इज यूज फॉर TKR. सो TKR, एज वी कैन सी इन दिस पिक्चर, टोटल नी रिप्लेसमेंट इज एक्चुअली ओनली अ रीसर्फेसिंग ऑपरेशन. सो ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड ऑफ द पिक्चर वी कैन सी डैमेज आर्टिकुलर सर्फेसिस बिकॉज ऑफ ऑस्टियोआर्थराइटिक चेंजेस एंड ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड वी कैन सी आफ्टर TKR हाउ इट विल लुक लाइक. सो ऑल द डैमेज पार्ट ऑफ द जॉइंट विल बी रिप्लेस्ड विद द आर्टिफिशियल कंपोनेंट. सो सर्फेसिस आर रिप्लेस्ड बाई आर्टिफिशियल कंपोनेंट्स इन TKR. So classification of implant designs, we have mainly two types of implant design. One is the unconstrained type and the second one is the constrained or the hinged type. So in unconstrained type of implant design, we have cruciate retaining, cruciate substituting and mobile bearing knees. So what is unconstrained design? In case of unconstrained implant design, there is no inherent stability in the implant design and it is used primarily with unicompartmental arthroplasty. In case of constrained implant design, it is significant congruency of the components will be there and most inherent stability but considerable limitation of the motion. So in case of constrained type of implant design, we will have some limitation of the motion. There is also semi-constrained type of implant design which provides some degree of stability with little compromise of mobility. So this is the unconstrained TKR design, how it will look like. So in unconstrained type of design, there is no inherent stability in the implant and it is used primarily with the unicompartmental arthroplasty. So this is the picture showing the constrained type of TKR prosthesis. So what is there in constrained type of TKR prosthesis? It will have significant congruency of the components that are the femoral component and the tibial component, and most inherent stability but considerable limitation of the range of motion. So constrained type of TKR implants will provide limitation in the range of motion. So this is the unicondylar TKR. In this unicondylar TKR, as you can see, only one condyle of the femur is replaced because the other condyle of the femur can be intact. And if the degeneration has occurred only in the one condyle of the femur, then only that side, one compartment can be changed with the artificial component. So we can have three types of TKR on the basis of compartment. We have unicompartmental TKR, bicompartmental TKR and tricompartmental TKR. So in unicompartmental TKR, only the medial or lateral joint surfaces are replaced. In the bicompartmental TKR, entire femoral and tibial surfaces are replaced. And in tricompartmental TKR, we have the femoral, tibial and patellar surfaces replaced. So these are the again different types of implant design. We have posterior stabilized design, cruciate retaining design and cruciate sacrificing design. So who is the right candidate for TKR? So quality of life, if it is severely affected after osteoarthritis of knee joint, then the patient can go for the TKR surgery. If the patient is experiencing daily pain, then he is the candidate for the TKR. Restriction of ordinary activities. So ADL, that is the activity of daily life. If the patient is finding difficult to perform the activities of daily life, then he can go for the TKR procedure. Evidence of significant radiographic changes of the knee. So as I have already discussed in my previous video, there OA knee is mainly classified based on the radiological criteria. So if there are significant changes on the x-ray, then the patient can go for TKR. So complication, what are the complications that are occurring after the TKR surgery? So main is the infection. The first one is the infection. There are chances that the patient may develop some kind of infection following the operative procedure. There is also chance of deep vein thrombosis. So it occurs as a result of immobility. So DVT is also one of the common complications after TKR. Nerve palsy can also develop. It is one of the complications after TKR. So common peroneal nerve palsy sometimes occurs in cases requiring dissection on the lateral side of the knee, but spontaneous recovery occurs in most cases. Then fractures are also common as a complication. So fractures may occur while performing the operation, particularly in osteoporotic bones of a bedridden rheumatoid patient. Fractures may occur late through the bones near the processes due to stress concentration in that area. So extensor mechanism complication also can be there. So this can occur because of handling of the extensor mechanism is required during the course of the operation, and this may occur due to avulsion of the patellar tendon, inadvertent cutting of the tendon. Knee stiffness can also develop, so the patient may not be able to regain the range of motion due to heterotrophic bone formation or intra-articular adhesion. So these are the complications that may arise following the TKR surgery. Pre-operative examination, so we have to take a complete medical history of the patient. Thorough physical examination should be done. Laboratory tests should be done and anesthesia assessment should be done pre-operatively. So this is the procedure of the TKR. We can see in the picture, firstly the surgeon is removing the degenerated part from the lower end of the femur. So end of femur is removed. So the second step, we can see the top of the tibia is removed. So in the osteoarthritis of the knee joint, the lower end of the femur as well as the upper end of the tibia, both the articular surfaces are degenerated. So the upper top part of the tibia will be removed. Next, the back of the patella will be removed. So in case of total knee replacement, if the osteoarthritic changes are also seen in the patella, then the surgeon will remove the posterior aspect of the patella. Next is the femoral implant is inserted. So after preparing the femoral condyles, the prosthesis will be put on the femoral condyle. Next is the tibial components will be inserted. So plastic spacer will be kept and metal tray will be inserted into the tibia. So we can see after preparing the tibial surface, the upper degenerated portion of the upper part of the tibia will be removed, and then the surgeon will put the tibial components. So next, the patellar implant will be inserted. So as we have already seen that the posterior aspect of the patella, if it is having degenerative changes, that will be removed, and then the surgeon will put the patellar implant. So this is the picture showing the total knee replacement surgery. The surgeon is preparing for the incision here in this picture. So this is the picture after the implant has been put. So we can see the femoral prosthesis and the tibial prosthesis in this picture. So this is the closing. After performing the surgery, the surgeon will put the sutures and close the incision. So this is the x-ray. This x-ray is taken after the surgery. So we can see on the left hand side, we can see the anterior view, and on the right hand side, we can see the lateral view. So in both the views, we can see the femoral prosthesis as well as the tibial prosthesis. So this is how the x-ray will look for the knee joint after the TKR surgery. So this is again the other x-ray, which is again showing the anterior portion. On the left hand side, we can see a x-ray which is taken for the patient who has undergone. Only one compartment of the knee joint is removed here. So unicompartmental TKR is done for this patient. So there is something called as partial knee replacement. It is done for a knee where only a part is damaged, that is the partial damage. So in this partial knee replacement, a small incision will be made. कैप इज पुट ऑन द टॉप ऑफ द डैमेज पार्ट विदाउट रिमूविंग एनी लिगामेंट्स एंड मसल्स एक्सेट्रा. इट इज़ अ इन्वेजिव प्रोसीजर एंड इट इज़ इंडिकेटेड इन पार्शली डैमेज नी. सो पार्शल नी रिप्लेसमेंट ऑल्सो कैन बी डन इन ट्राई कंपार्टमेंटल टीकेआर. वी आर रिमूविंग द फीमर. वी आर रिप्लेसिंग द पार्ट्स ऑफ द फीमर, द पटेला एंड द टीबिया. बट इन केस ऑफ पार्शल नी रिप्लेसमेंट, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ द पटेला इज नॉट शोइंग एनी डीजनरेटिव चेंजेस, देन ओनली द फीमोरल कंपोनेंट एंड द टीबियल कंपोनेंट कैन बी रिप्लेस्ड डिपेंडिंग ऑन द पेशेंट्स कंडीशन. सो दिस इज द यूनिकॉन्डाइलर टीकेआर. एज वी कैन सी इन दिस एक्सरे, ओनली वन कंपार्टमेंट ऑफ द फीमर और द वन कॉन्डाइल ऑफ द फीमर इज रिप्लेस्ड विद द आर्टिफिशियल कंपोनेंट. सो इन दिस केस वी कैन सी मेनली द ऑस्टियोआर्थराइटिस विल अफेक्ट द मीडियल कंपार्टमेंट ऑफ द नी जॉइंट. सो लेटरली वी कैन सी द फिब्युला बोन. And on the medial side, we can see that there were some the osteoarthritic changes in the medial condyle of the femur. So that has been replaced with the artificial prosthesis. Also, the medial aspect of the tibia has been replaced with the prosthesis. So this is the X-ray showing unicondylar TKR. So successful TKR depends on the precise surgical technique, sound implant design, appropriate material and patient compliance with rehabilitation. So rehabilitation is of great importance after the TKR surgery. Even if the TKR surgical procedure was successful but the patient does not perform the exercises regularly and the patient is not actively involved in the rehabilitation program which follows the surgery, then TKR procedure cannot be successful. So reference for today's video, I have taken the content from the book Essential Orthopedics by Maheshwari, 5th edition. So thank you for watching this video. If you have enjoyed watching this video, then please subscribe to my channel. Press the bell icon to get notified for the next video and share this channel with your friends. Thank you.